y'all right now, Lord, let me just touch Angie or minister to her right now to feel your power and your anointing. Then I find what this is and then fix it. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Okay, we're good. Like I said, first I want to ask you a question because I was told that the last couple of weeks, especially, but in general, last month I reckon, especially last couple of weeks, there's been kind of in-depth, intense on Sunday morning as far as messages. And I'm doing what I believe the Lord's leading, but I'm still just wanting to ask this question. I felt like this was an awesome way to ask. Do you feel with these things on marriage and family relationships that it's actually really very beneficial? Mm-hmm. Yeah. And would you like to keep hearing more?
Yes.
Okay. Do that. Well, I was going to do it anyway, but I'm going to ask you first. Just so you know, I'd answer. Really. I was going to ask. I mean, being led by the Lord. And if the Lord leads, I'm going to do it. You know what I'm saying? What I'm saying is like homecoming. I don't think everybody expects to go to homecoming and hear about how to make your home safe. You know, there was a lot of joking and carrying on, but there was some serious material, very serious material. And if you follow that material, matter of fact, last couple weeks you followed in that material, it's just amazing.
Sing.
You were holding your ear and you hit your head on the thing. I thought your hair was stuck. Oh, it's his ear. Look, I thought his hair was stuck in the recorder. It's his earpiece. I thought his hair was caught. He was trying to keep it.
Squirrel.
Okay, it's squirrel. Thank you. Yeah, around my house, they get on me all the time. Squirrel. Squirrel. Okay, but tonight what we're going to do is, and what this can do is two things. Number one, this can actually help me with future lessons, but also just a chance to let our hair down and ask some questions. So, everybody gets one, and make it legitimate, and make it a real question, okay? And legitimate, real, I mean, I'm looking at Curly especially.
Don't mind any questions like that progressive energy box. Where's your bed,
bud? Yeah, not that. Or like when Raymond's brother, what's his name? Raymond's brother is, everybody's Raymond? Uh-huh. Robert. Robert's a policeman in school, and he says, I'm here to answer questions today. And they said, are you a giant? He goes, that's not what I'm here to do. I got my police uniform on and said, are you going to eat us? I'm here to answer questions about the police. But the same way, everybody, and if I can't give you a great answer tonight, I will give you one. But everybody gets one biblical question tonight. And again, it may help even cause a chance to be a Bible study later. So, and we get to go to Curly first.
Oh. Give him a microphone so we can hear it.
Please start in the back.
That was your question? That was your question? The back keeps getting shorter. You're in the back now. Anything you'd like to ask about the Bible, especially about relationships, or your calling in God, or your purpose. But if you want to ask any kind of question, other than where did Lot get his,
Cain get his wife.
Cain get his wife. He got his wife in the land of Nod, and they said he knew his wife there, which meant he didn't necessarily get her there. It's there was where they procreated and had a child. And by the time, according to several biblical scholars, by the time Cain had gotten this period of time, it's a good possibility there was up to 10,000 people on the earth. But it's also a good possibility that it was his sister and or his cousin, and they weren't from, the land of Nod is right east of West Virginia, so it might have been his sister.
Oh, maybe.
Yes, really, it's probably his sister. And because God had to bring her from somebody. It's not like, at that time I'm pretty sure God took care of business. And there was not stuff like it is from today, intermarriage and the problems with intermarrying. So, so that question's out of the way. Snap. You get to go first, that's right.
There you go, right there.
How do you know if you're being led by God or your own thoughts?
That is a wonderful.
Ooh.
That's wonderful.
That's a heavy question.
Can I tell you something? Honestly, when you're being led by God and He's leading you, sometimes He's leading you through your thoughts. Okay? There's the way God speaks to us with the Holy Spirit. One of the number one ways God speaks to us with the Holy Spirit is through our conscience. Okay? And so if your conscience is telling you something is wrong, if it's checking you, if your conscience is checking you, know that God's in there checking you too. So your conscience is a great way that God talks to you when you're being led by the Spirit. Also, if you're being led by the Spirit, you're also going to feel a peace. Okay, there's going to be a peace there. And it's not going to necessarily be easy. It's not easy at all because it seems like every time He leads me, it's something that's pretty tight. You know, it's like just like packing up from Possum Track and moving to the Slate Stone. It's not what I wanted to do. But you know what? It's what I had to do. And now, it feels good in the morning just to walk to my father-in-law's and mother-in-law's versus get up at 6 and get ready to drive 20 minutes, you know, blah, 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 and just walk. Just walk down there, take care of business, walk by. And Bethany can go back and forth if she wants to. She doesn't stay there all day. Just whenever she wants to go, she can go. And Linda's getting rest because now she's sleeping at night. Bethany's spending the night. And I'm waiting. So it's been a blessing. Just the first week has been absolutely a blessing. So, you know, I knew in my conscience. And I also knew by just looking around. Plus, I said, Lord, if you really... It's like this. One day I asked the Lord one time, I was trying to lose weight and asked the Lord, you know, I want a donut. And so I rode right around Krispy Kreme and knew there was no parking spaces. And I said, Lord, if you want me to have a donut, you let a parking space be open. And I prayed that prayer in faith and I went up and up. On the 30th time around, one opened up.
30 minutes later.
No, really. So I asked God to help, and then we wound up going to, it was like we were trying to find the house, and I've told y'all the story, but the Lord, I was right there in front of the sandwich place, Schlossky's in New Bern, and while I was talking to Lynn on the telephone, the Lord spoke to me and said, tell her Psalm 107. And so I tell her, well, Psalm 107, she goes, what is that? I said, I have no idea. Okay, I said, but that's what God told me. And it says, I saw you in the wilderness, I saw you hurt, and I saw you exhausted. Okay, there's good. It said, I found you a safe place in the city. And so a door opened up 8 houses down from my mother-in-law, who actually was belonging to a pastor who just left and moved to Cherryville. And he's the first time I met him was in the lawyer's office while he was trying to close on their house. And he was upset. The lawyer told us when we were closing last week, said, I thank God so much for David and Linda because my people, these people were really having a bad time. They were about to lose it. Said David and Linda come in and calmed them right down and prayed with them. And he said, I was in such bad shape trying to handle it. I went out and bought pizza. Then I remember, he went out and bought pizza for us to eat while we were waiting. So, my conscience, okay? Not in my conscience. That was my number one leader right there. You know, I can't leave this woman. I can't leave this woman. And Linda, watching Linda deteriorate and watched her mama deteriorate, knowing that I could do something, not necessarily stop her mama from doing it. Well, even helping her mother, what we're doing is slowed it down because she has familiarity and she really enjoys Bethany being there. And she enjoys me being there in the morning. So that's been a blessing. And actually, but nighttime. But at the same time, I asked God, if this is you, Lord, open the door. And 8 houses down. There was the door. And I said, Lord, there's the door now. Show us how to take care of it. Show us how to take care of it. And so all these things, it's too many coincidences, so to speak, in there. And so I thank God for all this. Plus, the cool thing is about a mile from Paul Funeral Home, a little over a mile from hillside, sorry, I said north side, hillside, and I'm about a half a mile from the hospital. And so there's three main places I go to all the time. That way, I'm right there at that. That's pretty cool. So again, conscience. And then I pray in response to my conscience. God, if this is you talking to me, you got to show me. And then the door opens 8 houses down. And watch, Psalm 107. My address is 107 Slate Stone Drive. And so Linda's got this great little big thing she's put up on the wall, Psalm 107. He saw you to me. He said, I prepared you a safe place in the city. Wow. So again, if that answers your question, okay? Conscience. Remember, people think that your conscience is just you talking. Well, it is. It is your voice. But God's talking to you. It's like when Satan talks to you. You know what Satan uses? Your voice. That's how he scares you so bad, or sucks you in, because a lot of times he uses your own voice. And you're going, wow, I sure was stupid, Martin.
Amen.
I thought that was Beth. Was that Beth? It was. I said, I'm hearing her voice even right now. Okay. I really, or I knew I should, I mean, you know, whatever. So again, start with your conscience, and then then something to you to talk to God and say, God, is this you talking to me? Go to his word. There was the word, Psalm 107. His word. And then, you know, God make a way. He did. And so, you go to conscience, you go to his word, and you pray. Because as you pray for doors. Watch this. Doors to open and doors to shut. Okay? Some doors, I'm glad God shut. You know, Garth Brooks had one of the most awesome, can we use praise songs ever, and that was, I thank God for unanswered prayers.
Yeah.
Okay? So now.
But, you know, I disagree with that song.
Why is that?
Because all prayers are answered.
I think what he meant was.
No, I know what he meant, but all prayers are answered.
Yeah, they are. Every prayer is answered. Yes, no. Yes, no, or maybe.
Or wait.
Yes, later, or I got something better for you.
I mean, I like the song, but I like to say, oh.
Well, I think what he meant was it didn't answer the way he was expecting.
Yeah, I know that's what he meant.
Yeah, that's right. So now, did that answer your question? Does that answer everybody? Does that answer satisfactory to y'all too? Did it, good, bad, ugly, enlightened? Okay. What's that? The good, bad, and the ugly. Yeah. I thought we were like curling up. Which one's good, which one's bad, which one's ugly?
Well, it's still
blue. Oh, okay.